Hebrews.
Just appreciate God. I appreciate all everybody does. Wasn't the song service good this morning?
Amen.
Good songs. I appreciate that. Sometimes I may not say it enough, but those folks who pray and organize and feel the peace of God about songs, I appreciate that. I appreciate my wife. We're working here. It's a work in progress. I appreciate my wife singing, even when she has two little ones hanging on the bottom of her skirt and at her legs. Amen. Thank you, babe. She's wonderful. Amen. I appreciate everybody just being here, Sunday school teachers, and just everybody who does so much. Amen. We just couldn't do it alone, Sister Beth on the piano, Children's Church. She's out Children's Church and provides the environment on the piano there. I appreciate that. Hebrews chapter number 9. I'm going to start there. Keep your fingers in Hebrews because I'm going to turn back in Hebrews and read another verse. I want to look at Hebrews 9, then we'll jump back to Hebrews chapter number 7. I'm really going to focus really on verse number 12 of chapter number 9. However, just for the sake of context, I'd like to jump back to verse number 11 and read down to verse number 14. I'll reread 12 and then we're going to focus on that. I want to look at the redemption that Christ has provided. Amen. Redemption that comes to us through salvation. I'm not sure how I'd entitle it, but looking at redemption, looking at salvation that comes through redemption that you and I can have, and really just trying to paint a clear picture to us about something that is the most vital thing that we can know about the Word of God, and particularly here at the Easter season. The Word of God says, "But Christ, being come a high priest of good things to come, by a greater and more perfect tabernacle, not made with hands, that is to say, not of this building, neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood he entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us. For if the blood of bulls and of goats, and the ashes of a heifer sprinkling the unclean, sanctify to the purifying of the flesh, how much more the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God, purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God." Wow, there is a magnitude of information there. But let's look at verse number 12. "Neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood, he entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us." Chapter number 7, verse number 25, "Wherefore he is able also to save them to the uttermost that come unto God by him, seeing he ever liveth to make intercession for them." Amen. Let's pray. Father, I love you and I'm thankful for your faithfulness. Thankful for the precious Spirit of the Holy Ghost that I feel here tonight. God, thank you for answered prayer. Thank you for worship, God. Thank you for the word that's already been ministered. God, I invite you to move in the preaching of the word, God. Lord, I pray that tonight that it would just encompass every mind and every heart. Lord, I pray that our mind would be directed at what gave us redemption and the ability to be able to experience redemption through salvation. God, be glorified in this message. Encourage, strengthen, and inform. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Really, verse number 12, the whole theme of this verse is redemption of David. Redemption means to pay the ransom, to set someone free. To pay the ransom to set someone free. Thank God for the ransom that was paid for the freedom of you and I from sin. Amen. The Word of God says in Romans 6:17, Paul wrote and he said that we are all servants to sin. What does that mean? That we are responsible to do whatever sin has called us to do. We become captive to it. We become bound to it, that we serve sin. And so we need a redeemer. Thank God that He is a redeemer. Amen. This captivity that has all of us bound. Amen. The captivity that kept us from heaven. Amen. The captivity that keeps us from living life free from sin. God, He gave His Son for a ransom for you and I, that we may be redeemed. Redeemed, how I love to proclaim it. Redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Redeemed tonight. So I want to look at three things as we look at this first verse this evening. If I could divide it up really in a simple way, I'm sure that it can be much more complex. But I want to look at three things. The first thing I want to look at is the payer of redemption. We find the Bible says, neither by the blood of goats and of calves, but by His own blood. Amen. By His own blood, having obtained eternal redemption for us. By His blood, we are redeemed tonight by the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. I know it's elementary, amen, but it is profound. That we are redeemed by the blood of Jesus Christ. He is the one who paid our redemption. He came to earth, amen, some 2,000 years ago. Matthew 28 says, the Son of Man, or Jesus Christ, came not to be ministered unto, but to minister and give His life for a ransom for many. Thank God that on Calvary, that redemptive blood was spilled. Amen. He redeemed us. He bought us. You see, these people that He was sharing with, they were familiar very much. These Hebrew Christians were familiar with animal sacrifices. And so He wanted them to know that there is no animal sacrifice, amen, that is adequate to pay for our sins. They're only a foreshadow of Jesus Christ coming and Him giving His blood. There's not baptism, there is not confirmation, there is not catechized, there is not church membership that will redeem your soul. The only thing that will redeem it is the blood of the Lamb. He came and gave His life for a ransom, Brother Steve, for you and I. Amen. Neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by His own blood. There is nothing that you and I could have done. Amen. Christ did it all. He paid the ransom. Paid in full by the blood of Jesus Christ. Wow. Amen. That's huge tonight. That He is the payer of redemption. What would you feel like? How do you feel? If any of you have ever experienced this before, where someone's ahead of you in line and they pay for your food. You feel overwhelmed, you feel appreciative, however that is. You go to pay for a bill and you find out someone's already paid it for you. I mean, it's a phenomenal feeling. Amen. That's minute compared to the redemptive work of Jesus Christ. If the world could sink their teeth into what God has done for humanity, and they could experience it through salvation. Amen. This church would be packed. The foyer would be packed. There would be people standing in the parking lot. Amen. If they recognized, amen, what He did to pay for redemption. Let me say this tonight. I don't know a lot of details, but I looked at the headlines enough to know that what was there, 50 people in Egypt who died, 40, 50, and over 100 that are wounded. because of ISIS on Christians on Palm Sunday. You're right, Sister Beth. Amen. We are blessed. But those folks who were there, I believe that they were there even in the face of danger, Brother Dennis, because they knew who paid for their redemption. So the payer of redemption by his own blood. The Bible says that he, or Jesus Christ, and Jesus Christ is the payer of redemption. The price of redemption was by his blood. The price certainly was not cheap. The price was very high. It was so great that no man could have paid for redemption on his own. I love what Psalms 49 says. Let me read that to you. They that trust in their wealth and boast themselves in the multitude of their riches, none of them can by any means redeem his brother, nor give unto God a ransom for him. As wealthy as the wealthiest person is, Brother David, they could not have the power to redeem themselves, or Brother Justin, redeem their brother. It would not work in the sight of God. But Jesus, by his own blood, amen, by his own blood, the Bible says, he redeemed, amen, he entered into the holy place once, and he obtained eternal redemption for us. I know that we live in a world, listen to me for a few moments, we live in a world that loves to nullify evil. Sin is still sin. Sin will not enter into the kingdom of God, for the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. The gift is redemption. The world is working for minimum wage. I don't know if it's anyone's apple cart, but when minimum wage isn't really designed for you to have a house or a car and a family, and it's kind of an entry level. If folks have to work minimum wage, God can provide. But most folks move up above minimum wage because it is something you don't want to be stuck there at minimum wage. Give me up, boost me. But the world is living at minimum wage, for the wages of sin is death. Amen. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. The price of redemption, amen, was the blood of Jesus Christ. Our righteousness, Isaiah says, is as filthy rags. We couldn't do it on earth. We need the blood of Jesus. That is what Easter is about. I need a Savior. I need a Redeemer. I need someone to pay my ransom. The Bible says that he entered in once into the holy place. And it was by his blood that he secured eternal redemption for us. The payer is Jesus Christ. The price of redemption is the blood. Amen. The blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. And his blood is not only valuable, but it is available to all sinners. The third thing that I see here in Hebrews 9:12 is the permanency of redemption. Thank God for the payer, Jesus Christ. Thank God for the price, his blood. But thank God for the permanency of redemption. The Bible says, having obtained eternal redemption for us. Now, it's not the time for a theological debate, but I just let me debunk this right now. You can lose your salvation.
Because you can choose to walk away from the grace of God. And walking away from the grace of God, we say to Jesus Christ, I don't value your blood. I don't value redemption. I don't value eternity. I walk away. I'm living my life. But for those who know the payer, Jesus Christ, and for those who've had the price of the blood applied to them, amen, and they're concerned about their eternity, amen, the blood of Jesus Christ is good for eternity. Amen. We don't have to do anything. Amen. We don't have to do anything to gain any more salvation. I can't eat a certain way or dress a certain way or act a certain way that would achieve more salvation. Salvation is only given through the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. And it is good for eternity. It'll never wear out. It'll never wear thin. It'll never dry up. Amen. It is still valid. The blood of Jesus Christ. He shed his blood so that we can have redemption forever. Brother David, I heard you this morning and you said, this season, 40 years ago, I gave my life to Jesus. 40 years is nothing to blink an eye at. There's a lot of water on the bridge in 40 years. But it's nothing compared to eternity. And the same blood that's kept you 40 years is the same blood that will keep you and every other son of God throughout eternity. Why was Calvary important? Because we need a ransom. The blood wasn't adequate enough from goats and calves and animals. We need the blood of God's own Son. Thank God for blood. I love how we can build upon this in Hebrews 7:25. Wherefore he, or Jesus, is able to save them to the uttermost that come unto him, or Jesus. Seeing that he, or Jesus, once again, ever liveth to make intercession for them. It is necessary that the soul has salvation. He's the Redeemer. He's bought redemption for eternity. The only thing that we need to do is robe ourselves in the blood of Jesus Christ and experience the redemption that the Word of God calls salvation. Neither is there salvation in any other. And so, he is the Christ of salvation. He is able, the Word of God says, to save. Who can save? Jesus can save. He's the only one that can. He's referred here three times in pronouns. He, him, and he. If you leave Christ out of salvation, amen, there is no other way to be saved. We must have Jesus Christ for salvation. Amen. Why is Easter so important? Because we need Jesus Christ. Amen. Why is Palm Sunday so important? Amen. Even if others misunderstood and misconstrued, amen, he was determined that for the hour that God sent him, amen, that the world needed a Savior and he would die and be the ransom, amen, to bring salvation to man's soul. An angel can't give it to you. Money can't give it to you. No church, no person can give it to you. Only Jesus can give it to you. Amen. The Word of God, amen, reminds us that he is able to save us to the uttermost. Amen. Because he ever liveth. You know what means? What he means by ever liveth? Amen. Because he's resurrected from the grave. Amen. He died upon the cross. Dying gave us the blood, Brother Craig. Amen. But we need a validation, Brother Justin, through the resurrection. Amen. He ever liveth. And the only way to be saved is by a living God. He's not in someone's borrowed tomb. Amen. His body hasn't been drawn away. Amen. But we know that he was seen by over 500 people after his resurrection. He is alive. Amen. They watched him ascend.
And the Word of God tells us that He sits on the right hand of God, ever making intercession. Why? Because Sister Barbara, He had to appease the wrath of God, and His work is finished, and He sits there praying for us. And Sister Tina, we can experience salvation.
Hallelujah. The Word of God says in 1 Timothy 2:5, there is one God and there is one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus. In 1 Corinthians 3:11, the Word of God says, other foundation can no man lay than that is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. Amen. He is salvation. Amen. There's no other way. He is able. So the Christ of salvation, the character of salvation, we know that He's done the redemptive work. He's the Christ of salvation. But what's the character of salvation? The Bible says that He is able to save them to the uttermost. Now I know that we probably have heard this before, that Christ can save anyone, even to the uttermost. Some say even to the guttermost. And certainly that is true. God can save from the gutter. But that's not necessarily what this word uttermost is talking about here. He's talking about, in the Greek it would be better translated, He is able to save them completely. Now there is nothing that is left out. God is able to save completely. That means when He gets into us, Brother David, amen, He gets in our life and He saves us. We don't have to question, am I saved? Amen. When He gets in, amen, and He begins to work in our heart, amen, He changes us. And when He says, come now and let us reason together, amen, we reason with Him. We allow Him in, amen, we confess our sins. We find that He's faithful and just to forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. The work of the cross changes to the uttermost. The character of salvation will change a person completely. Brother David, we had a conversation just yesterday, I believe. As I was preparing for the service, you gave validation for some things that I was thinking. We live, and I know that I've said this before, but I just need to bring it again. We live in a church generation that wants to be a consumer. They come to get all they can from God. Sister Barbara, they come to get from God. The problem of it is they never start out with adjusting by giving to God. Completely. Everything about them. And I believe this. I believe that we will be blessed by God. But God doesn't save us to bless us. God saves us that we can work for Him and that we can love Him. Amen. He wants to change us completely. If a Sunday morning religion only brings us a little bit of feeling good as we worship, amen, and it's a flattery message that's all about self-help, that's not salvation. God gets in our life and He changes us. He changes the way that we think. He changes everything about us. The condition of our soul, where we were once dead in our sins, now are we quickened and we are alive in Him. We take up our cross and we follow Him. Our life is no longer lived for ourselves, but it is lived for eternity. Amen. We continue to keep ourselves in a place where eternal salvation is secure because we value it. We sell all that we may buy the pearl of great price. The character of salvation. You can call upon Him and He'll save you. He'll do it. God is not just an ingredient of salvation, but He's the complete. You don't need your name on America Bible Church. You don't need catechize. I believe water baptism is good. We should do that. Amen. But baptism won't save you. The complete work of salvation is done through the character of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, seeing that he ever liveth to make intercession for them. He is able to save them to the uttermost that come unto God by him. So we've looked at the Christ of salvation, the character of salvation. The third and final thing we'll look at tonight is the coming for salvation. There's some things we can do proxy. Brother Doug, you're sick. Unable to be at church, I'll stand in for you by proxy. Brother Justin, I may need to do something for you by proxy because you can't be here. But for every one of us in here, salvation can't be by proxy. It has to be each one of us coming individually to God. He is able to save them to the uttermost that come unto God by him. One day Christ is coming, and only those who've experienced salvation will be ready. You're right, Brother David. A lot of folks get that second coming. He's coming back. He's not coming back to earth. I want to be part of when he comes back. I want to meet him in the air. I want to be ready for that day when the trumpet's going to sound. Amen. This old body, amen, is going to put on uncorruptibleness. This mortality will put on immortality. He's coming back, but only for those who are saved. Sister Beth, if you come to the piano tonight, intentionally tonight, I feel like I wanted the service to focus on what Easter is about. That we need a Redeemer. We need someone to pay the ransom. And he did. He did on the cross. The cross is enough to save. Nothing else. Because anything else I would try to do on my own to be a substitute for that will not come to the mark. Or anything that I think I need to throw in my flavor or my spice to help me be saved just won't work. It's only by the blood of Jesus Christ. By his own blood, he entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us. He was the payer of redemption. His blood was the price of redemption. I'm thankful for the permanency of redemption. There's not another message, Sister Barbara. Another one, Brother George. It's the blood of Jesus Christ. It prevails. Redemption has been given. It's not for those who simply believe. There's a lot to believe. And Brother Doug, every week I hear folks saying, well, I believe. I'm not worried about what you believe. What does the Word of God say? And I don't mean that to be offensive, but what you and I believe or think is very jaded. We were born into sin. And so our minds, our conscience is dead in itself. We need a Savior to bring it to life. And so he says that he is able to save us to the uttermost that come unto God by him, seeing that he ever liveth to make intercession for them. The message of Easter is this, that he is the Redeemer. But redemption is only applied if we come to God by him. He ever liveth
to make intercession.
So he's the Christ of salvation. The character of salvation is it will change you completely. Let me ask you this tonight. Has salvation changed everything about your life? Because if it hasn't gotten to every area, it's time to get back in touch with the mediator. He ever liveth to make intercession.